Vijay, can we hear from you now?
I am not commenting on the great interviews which you have done. I am commenting more on myself, that whenever we talk about non-violence and quest for non-violence, people like me are more in the legacy or the continuity of non-violence movement in India, and which is more based on the moral resources of non-violence, whereas the Hind Swaraj lays down whole lot of issues which are source of violence, like modernity. Now, if we deconstruct the modernity, then the development model, the way we are treating our Adivasis, we have the largest Adivasi proportion in the world, and the way their knowledge systems, which is the biggest violence we are having, we don't recognize their knowledge systems as such. So, development model is one. Growth-oriented, corporate model-based economy is second. So we have to almost cater as a community practicing non-violence. We have to at least catalog the sources of violence and structural violence, and then have a counter theory and practice to how to count. For example, Ashish Nandi raises the idea of nation state creating violence. Now, it's not just idea of nation state, it's the idea of strong boundaries, sense of boundaries of any identity variety, be it caste variety, be it really around religions, be it around nations, be it even around economic categories, like the lower class white, whom we pejoratively called white supremacists, but the way they have been socialized, they think they are deprived. So this strong sense of identities without an idea of concentric circle of identities and aspiration to move to universal identities without being uprooted and becoming unrooted. So having all the circles of dimensions of identity retaining and still having universalism, like Gandhi is one great example of this kind of, he was as authentic Hindu as anybody else, and he was as universal as any secular, liberal, universalist, modern person. So these sources of structural violence and sources of political economy related structural violence, they all have to become part of our consciousness and the counter strategy in our quest for non-violence. And in case of India, the kind of violent communities are being actively created from amongst Hindus, the kind of from amongst Muslims, more subterranean way. Similarly, many of the marginalized communities, Adivasis and Dalits, some of the grassroots leadership is creating a kind of social secessionism among them. They are creating a leadership which is not, which will not cater to the entire society. So if they become only sectional leader, Dalit leader, Adivasi leader, there is bound to be violence. So we have to address these issues collectively as a community.